getting it all ready and have it painted once again. So we made it back, got back into our bunks about 5:15. About 5:30, the PIs, drill instructors came through and got us all out of bed. We're going for a 20-mile march. So off we go. I really wanted to learn how to shoot 160, and I qualified an expert. That's what I carry during that 20-mile march. To the front, to the rear, to the flanks, to the front, to the rear, to the flanks. We got back so late that we missed supper. We did not have breakfast. We had C rations for lunch. We got back so late we missed supper, and a lot of people, a lot of the guys, been hungry. I went over to the mess hall to see what was available. All they had were these huge, huge pots of cooked spinach. I hated vegetables. And I was so hungry. Well, can't be that bad, I'll try it. So I had a plate full of cooked spinach, a little butter, salt, and pepper. It was delicious. It was probably one of the best meals I've ever had in my life. I went back, I had seconds, I had thirds, eight, and I could eat it all if I wanted to. You know, it was the first time in my life that I began to get the thought into my head, maybe I didn't have it so bad anymore. Maybe that little town I was growing up in, maybe it wasn't so bad. Okay. We get over to Vietnam. Now, we were there probably, we see the intense Iowa station, we were in Ordnance Company station in Longview, and we moved ammunition around all day, all night. And we slept in tents. And those of you who are in Vietnam, you know what it's like. It's hot, it's humid, it smelled a little good. And whatever garbage we had in our tents that we were allowed to eat or drink, we put it in bags. Once a week, we put it out the edge of the road, and somebody would come and dispose of it for us. And I walked by and I saw a bunch of my fellow soldiers looking, peeking out the door, and I thought, what's going on? Oh, here comes a family. Old papa, son, old grandfather, long white whiskers, his wife, children, little children. They go to our garden. I grew up in a small town. I'd never seen anything like that before. I didn't know that you could be so hungry that you would eat someone else's garbage that was sitting in the sun, rotting. So I opened her for me. And I still couldn't figure out what these guys were doing, looking out to do that. How to pretend. They ended up watching this papa-san as he tipped back a little bottle of wine, looking for a little bit that might be up in the corner to have a little drink of it. What these guys had done is they had beaten him. And I was so disgusted that they had done that, that we had words. And I told them what would happen if I ever saw them do that again. They never did that again. But I wondered if my dad would be proud of me, knowing that I was part of this. Then I thought about it. This is just help stop communism in the world. We just help stop this kind of communism. It's hard to find it at that point. We had a mama-san or a woman that used to come into our tent every day, and she would clean our boots when we came back from the field. They were all muddy, dirty. She'd stitch them for us. She'd take our dirty clothes. It took two soldiers to lift this probably 75, 80 pounds of laundry on her head. And she would walk 10 miles down, 10 miles, with this laundry on her head. And then she'd wash it all night long by hand. And then she'd iron it. She'd bring it back the next day. She'd have a washing machine. I was pretty impressed. She could speak pretty good English in her husband had been killed by the NVA in the Vietnamese Army. And after we'd been there about 10 months, I sat down next to her and I said, are you glad we're here? And She just looked at me. And she answered. A couple days later, she kind of waiting over, and I went over and I sat down by her. She says, "No. No, I'm not glad that you're here." He says, "Arlo, you ruined our economy. Many of our women have turned to prostitution. What's going to happen to us when you leave?" I know why. And I wonder if my dad would call it what we're doing. See, it's sort of totally certain what we're doing. And I wonder, are we stopping communism in this world? I just think that we were at that point. We hadn't seen it. Last thing she said to me, as we got up and walked away, she said, "Why do you call us loose?" I turned around and looked at her. I didn't know what to say. She said, "You call us loose because it's easier to kill us." That was a shame. That's the truth. On that same time, I began to think about the enemy that we had been fighting, that had fought the French before we got there, that were fighting us, that lived underground, moved their supplies on bicycles, ate little more than rice, did not have anywhere near the technology that we did, and yet they seemed to be winning. And I looked at them, and I began to admire what they were doing. And I felt so guilty for that. To this day, I still feel guilty for that. And I thought, you know, they are doing what my ancestors, the Lakota warriors, did in this country for years. And they're doing what every one of us, not just here, but throughout the entire United States, would do to the very end that took 100 years if our country was invaded. They're doing the same thing. And yet I had friends that had lost limbs. I had friends that were killed over there. And I felt so guilty for feeling that way. And I just thought, I don't think my dad would be proud of me. And so basically, when I left Vietnam, I didn't have a lot of time when I left home. When I got to Madison on Labor Day, so I decided it was a beautiful, sunny, blue sky day, and I'm going to walk. My brother lived in Madison. I was going to walk to his house. And after a mile or so, I decided that picture. I had no idea what was going on in this country at that time, but we were over there. We were pretty well insulated, what was going on. So a car pulls over, I told my thumb on, the car pulls over, I run out. Why they spit on me. I had no idea why they did that. Tried it again, the same thing happened. After a couple of, maybe 20 minutes later, there was a restaurant nearby. I was thirsty, so I went in to get a Kool-Aid and sat down at the table. And everybody around me